You know
well,
that.
Well, yeah, wind's going to be a factor. This is intimidating, by the way. So we're right in front of Fresno State's bench over here. And Fresno State's right over here. And so protecting both the camera and the opponents tonight is Matt. And we've warmed up a little bit. But I've been inconsistent, right, Matt? Not everything is hit here. So let's just see. Yeah!
A little high. A little high.
So, Matt, I'm curious, how was that? Would that, I mean, 60 feet, 6 inches.
60 feet, 6 inches. That's pretty good. That plays.
Yeah,
that gets
yeah.
on the field.
That gets on the field. That's all that matters. Okay. Obviously, wind a big factor today. We've been talking about the weather all day long. What does it look like? Here's a look at my forecast. Well, that's a little earlier in San Luis Obispo, and you can see the camera shaking around a little in that big wind outside. The reason for that is that high pressure is building in behind that cold front that snaked down the Sierra Nevada this morning. Still a few cumulus clouds off to our east, and that continues to be the case as we go into tomorrow. You can see a system trying to drop in from the north, and like this last one, it won't have a direct impact in terms of rain, but the change in pressure will continue to drive the winds into tomorrow. So let's jump into tomorrow's forecast here. You can see some pretty nice numbers in terms of daytime highs in Paso Robles, but look at the winds. Northwest 15 to 25 miles per hour, again picking up as early as say 11 o'clock. In Santa Maria, the daytime highs do well, but look at the winds, 20 to 30 again as we go into tomorrow. San Luis Obispo, well, it's going to be another windy day as well. The numbers look fine, getting back up into the 60s again, but 15 to 25, 30 mile per hour winds likely in the afternoon. Here's a look at the microclimate model. You can see not a lot of cloud cover. All that wind really does scour it out. However, there's that front I'm talking about trying to nose into the area Thursday. Sweeps through really quickly, but again, it's just going to help keep wind a factor in the forecast going into the weekend, even into early next week as well. Let's take a look at the satellite radar. You can see some rain out there across Nevada and the Sierra Nevada mountains. Locally, again, just a few cumulus clouds off to the east. High wind warning in place for the Santa Barbara County Mountains. Winds up to 65 miles per hour through 3 a.m. The other advisories, a wind advisory for the Central Coast. We anticipate the winds to start to diminish after sunset tonight at 8 o'clock. Wind advisory for the interior will hold to 3 a.m. as well, with winds gusting up to 45 miles per hour, and the south coast through 3 a.m. with wind gusts up to 50, but sustained 20 to 30. There you can see the modeling showing the winds backing off a little into tomorrow morning, but picking up as we get into the afternoon and evening again on Wednesday. So wind is a factor in this forecast. There's back on Thursday. Here are the numbers. Daytime highs right around 70 degrees tomorrow. And the south coast, because that's not a direct onshore wind, we'll get some mid-70s. Five cities, upper 60s, low 70s, deeper interior, overnight lows near 40 degrees, and daytime highs in the 60s and low 70s. Five-day forecast shows temperatures not really going anywhere, maybe cooling down a little for the south coast heading into the weekend. Paso Robles, North County warming up by Saturday, and San Luis Obispo, temperatures upper 60s, low 70s. Big thanks to Matt. Good luck to you guys tonight. It's going to be Cal Poly against Fresno State, 6 o'clock here at Bagot. We're right in front of the Cal Poly bench. Good luck, you guys. Let's win this one tonight, and I hope to see you out here at the game. Until then, back to you.